Hello everyone, my name is Arun Kumar and I'm your instructor for the module on password managers. In the previous module, we had learned about basics of a secure password, how to create a secure password, how to change it, and how to remember it. While remembering, we can use password managers. On today's module, we will discuss different available password managers. In this module, the learning objectives are: we will see what are password managers. We will also learn about different types of password managers. We will go through features about different password managers available in the market. Let us start. Remember the same question I asked you in the previous module: how many websites are there in which you have to supply a username and a password combination to use their services? As per research, at least 5 websites. There are a host of different websites like social networking websites, online banking websites, e-commerce websites, blogs, emails, and so on and so forth. Let us go to a login screen and understand what we supply to avail a particular website's services. We supply a username, we supply a password. The username is the identification part. You identify yourself. The password is the authentication part. When you give your password, you are authenticated against your identity. I say, my name is Arun, and when I give the password, the database of the website authenticates and says, yes, this is Arun's password. And now Arun is allowed to enter the website and use the services. So this is how it works. Now it has become very difficult to remember each combination, change it every month, remember it, protect it. So to make that easy, protecting that password, we have password managers. Password managers allow you to store, backup, and manage your passwords. So this becomes an alternative to remembering your passwords. You don't have to remember, you just have to remember a single master password which will enable other passwords on websites. So if you have a very good password, when I say a good password, that means a very strong password, not easily guessable password, not key sequences, not common dictionary names. A good password is a combination of uppercase letters, lowercase letters, symbols, numbers. And when that password becomes a good password, it becomes hard to remember it. So if it is hard to remember it, a password manager comes in handy. To give a very bookish definition to it, let us see what is a password manager. Simply put, it is a software that helps a user to manage passwords and important information so that it can be accessed anytime and anywhere. An excellent password manager helps to store information securely without compromising safety. All the passwords are saved using some kind of encryption. When we say some kind of encryption, it means every password manager will have its own encryption, its own algorithm, and its own key mechanism to encrypt your password in a state which is not easily decryptable, easily guessable, or crackable. So they become difficult for others to exploit. The question is why you should use it. If you find it hard to remember passwords for every website and don't want to go through the forgot password way every now and then, I think the answer for your trouble is a password manager. So, how does password managers work? Password managers, after installing, may store passwords online or locally. Online password managers information may be stored in an online cloud, which obviously can be accessed from anywhere and any device. When the password manager is local, the information about the username password combination is stored locally, which obviously has a demerit that then the password combination is only accessible on the local device. Suppose if you install that password manager on your computer, it will only be accessible from your computer. Nonetheless, both have their own advantages and disadvantages, and the password manager that you want to choose will totally depend on your need. One more thing about online password managers is that they use browser extensions that keep data in a local profile as well, and then they sync that local profile with a cloud server. Some other password managers use removable media such as a USB or a CD-ROM to save the password so that you can carry it with you and don't have to worry about having it online. So when you use those password managers which has a USB token attached with them, your passwords are saved on USB token with encryption. When you move from your home PC to office PC, you can carry that token and use your passwords. Another advantage with hardware token is that this can be combined as a two-factor authentication mechanism so that your data is even more secure. So when I say two-factor authentication, remember when we learned about identification and authentication? Your username is the identification part. The authentication part is the password. And when you supply that password and insert the hardware token becomes the second factor. That makes it two-factor authentication. There are also multiple factor authentication mechanisms available, but as security says, you use a particular device depending on the asset you are protecting. So if you are only protecting some document file, you may use only a password and a hardware token combination rather than going for multi-factor authentication mechanisms involving biometric, iris scans, or finger scanners. Let us see an algorithm which is used by most password managers to store your password in an encrypted form. The algorithm's name is TwoFish algorithm, TwoFish algorithm. It is actually based on Blowfish algorithm. Blowfish algorithm came into the limelight after the US department had a competition on advanced encryption standards, and Blowfish was one of the five finalists on that competition. Though Blowfish was not selected, the other algorithm, Rejandl algorithm, was selected, but it gained much popularity and a second version of Blowfish was formed, which is called the TwoFish algorithm. It is a symmetric key algorithm, a block cipher based algorithm. For now, just understand that it uses 128 bits of block, and the key size ranges from 128 bit, 192 bit, and 256 bit combination. So it is a popular algorithm which is essentially based on the Feistel cipher algorithm, which has 16 rounds of processing before encrypting your plain text. It is used in several password managers. We will see them in the next slides. The best password managers use a 256 bit or more encryption protocol for better security, which has been even accepted by the US National Security Agency for top secret information handling, which means the highest level of data classification is allowed to be stored on a password manager which uses an encryption protocol of 256 bit or more size. The first in the line that we would like to discuss as a password manager is KeePassX. It is an open source software which is also cross-platform and very lightweight password management application. It is published under the terms of the GNU General Public License, which means that you can use it for free and distribute it. When I say open source, the source code is available for you to distribute, modify, and give it and publish it. When I say this is software is a cross-platform software, that means it works on Windows, it works on Linux platform, and it also works on Mac platform. It was built on the Qt libraries. In fact, KeePassX stores information about usernames, passwords, and other login information in a secure database. It uses its own random password generator, which makes it easier to create strong passwords for better security. It also includes a powerful and quick search tool with which a keyword of a website can be used to find login credentials that have been stored in the database. That means if you have saved a password for a particular website and you do not remember where is that password, you can enter the keyword from the website in the tool and the tool will select the password and give it to you. It also allows users to customize groups, making it more user-friendly. KeePassX is not only limited to storing only usernames and passwords, but also free form notes and any kind of confidential text files. So suppose there is very important information and you think that information is very confidential to you, you can note down the particular information in this software and it will save it with encryption. This is how the graphical user interface of the KeePassX is appearing. I have given this GUI from Ubuntu Linux platform. It is more or less similar to the Windows and Mac platform. The top left hand corner tells you about generating a password, saving it, and different options to log into websites, locking it. You can create different groups of password managers. Like there can be an internet group which has all the passwords which related to your websites. There can be an email group wherein you save username, URL, and password related to email providers like Outlook, Gmail, Yahoo, etc. And when you right click on those passwords, you get options to copy the password to clipboard, open the particular URL, you can perform auto type, you can add a new entry, you can edit it, you can clone it or delete it. Few features which are very relevant to KeePassX is it has a very simple user interface. You know, you do not need to have too much technical knowledge to operate the user interface. It is self-explanatory. The left pane tree structure makes it easy to distinguish between different groups and entries, while the right pane shows more detailed information about the particular entry. It is also portable. It has a portable media access. Its portability makes it easy to use since there's no need to install it on every computer. It has a search function which searches in the complete database or in every group. It also has a feature which is called autofill. There's no need to type in the login credentials. The application does it whenever the web page is loaded. This keeps it secure from keyloggers. Keyloggers, to understand it for now, are softwares with malicious intent. They get installed on your computer and capture your key presses. When you press the keyboard, they capture it, and that particular software might transmit it to a evil mind hacker or a cracker sitting somewhere far, far away who wants to know your username or password. So with this, the KeePassX keeps it away from key presses. It autofills, auto types them, and you don't need to press the key and nobody can catch your key presses. It also has a interesting feature of a password generator. This feature helps to generate strong passwords that make it difficult for dictionary attacks. It can be customized as well. Remember, we studied dictionary attacks in the previous module, wherein you should not use common words found in dictionary which are prone to attacks. The advantage of this particular password generator is that you don't have to remember this complex password which is not easily guessable. The password manager does it for you. The next feature of KeePassX is ability to have a two-factor authentication. So you can enable this two-factor authentication by enabling the user to either unlock the database by a master password or by a key from a removable drive. So you have a removable drive and it can store a key, and then when you try to enter the password on the website, the second factor comes from the USB key. Another feature of KeePassX is when it allows you to add attachments. Attachments like any confidential information that you think that is very dear to you and you want to save it under encryption, it can be saved onto KeePassX and it then will be added to the database as an attachment, which allows user to secure not just passwords but all your sensitive documents as well. Another feature about KeePassX, as I already said, it is a cross-platform support. It works on all supported platforms. KeePassX is an open source application, so its source code can be compiled and used for any operating system. Another important feature of KeePassX is that the password database is encrypted with either the AES encryption or the two-fish algorithm. The AES being the advanced encryption standard, which uses 256-bit key encryption. Remember when we told that a good password manager, according to the US department, is the one which uses 256-bit key size or more. So whether it is AES or two-fish, they both use 256-bit key for encryption. That means increased security for your password storage. Another important feature of the KeyPassX is that you can set an expiration date for the passwords. You know, your password can expire after a certain date. So when you try to enter it after a certain date, or somebody who has stolen your password tries to enter it, it might have already expired. And when you yourself try to enter it, it will ask you to reset it. So that makes it another layer of security. You can also import and export the entries from password manager or KeyWallet, and entries entered in the password manager, KeyPassX, can be exported as text files. So these text files can be imported in other wallets and exported from those wallets to KeyPassX. Interestingly, the KeyPassX supports 15 different languages. That was all with the KeyPassX software. Let's see another password manager which is popular in the market. The name is Clippers. Clippers is a web-based tool. It is open source password manager built to store login information securely. Data, in the sense your password and other data, can be accessed from anywhere and from any device without any installation. Why without any installation? Because it is web-based. You need to enter the website address of Clippers, and then your particular account will open and all your passwords will be seen there being stored. It also includes an offline version. Whenever the internet connection is not available and you want to use the password, the offline version can help you to retrieve passwords and use it. On the left side, you get your account info and your direct logins. There are different menu items where you can set your password, your entries for different websites, create groups and entries. Features about the Clippers software: the web-based solution has a direct login wherein it automatically logs into any website without typing login credentials with just one click. This helps to avoid being captured by keyloggers. It also gives you offline data access with one click. An encrypted local copy of the data can be created as a HTML page. That's an offline data that you can have. Also, since it is a web-based solution, a web-based application, it doesn't require any installation and can be accessed from any compatible browsers. Login data, which is stored, can be imported from different supported password managers. Suppose you have a password manager file on a particular software which is application based, which is local, which is platform based, and you now want to move to a web-based solution like Clippers, you can export the data from there and import in Clippers. The database is encrypted using JavaScript code on the browser and then sent to the website. It requires a passphrase to decrypt the database, without which data cannot be accessed. All those web browsers that have JavaScript enabled, Clippers supports them, and it works smoothly on any system which has a major browser, popular browser, and has JavaScript enabled. The next password manager that we would like to discuss is Password Gorilla. Password Gorilla is again an open source, cross-platform, simple password manager and a personal vault that can store login information and notes as well. That means attachments as well. It also works on Linux, it works on Windows platform, it works on Mac OS X platform as well. The login information is stored in the database, which can be accessed only using a master password. That means rather than having multiple passwords to be remembered, you remember only one master password. The passwords are SHA-256 protected. I would like to pause here and tell you what is SHA-256. So SHA-1 and SHA-256, MD5, these words you will come across when you study cybersecurity and encryption and cryptography. So quickly, if you understand it today, these are hashing algorithms. They generate a hash, a fixed length hash. So the beauty of these algorithms are this, that if you enter a variable length input, suppose you give an input which is of length say 1024 bytes, it will produce an output which is 256 bit only. Now take the same case and input a value which is 512 bytes. It will still output you a fixed length 256 bit hash. So hashing algorithms are those algorithms, those mechanisms which has variable input size but fixed output length. So SHA-256 is one of them. The others are SHA-1, MD5 and many more. So for now, understand that SHA-256 will produce an output of 256 bit only. Moving on, the passwords in this software are SHA-256 protected and the database is encrypted using the two-fish algorithm. The key stretching feature makes it difficult for brute force attacks. This is the GUI captured from the Ubuntu OS platform of the software, the password Gorilla software. Let us see the features. It is designed to run on a compatible computer without being installed. So that means it is portable. That is one feature. Again, it provides you the feature of importing the database. Suppose you have a password database stored in a CSV format, comma separated value format. You can import it to Password Gorilla and it will save it with encryption. So whenever this password manager is idle, it locks the database. So you can set the specific period of time after which the database gets locked. This password manager again uses the two-fish algorithm, which encrypts the database. It can also copy credentials. Keyboard shortcuts can be used to copy login credentials to the clipboard. Another feature which Password Gorilla has is that you can set a specific time after which the entries, the clipboard are cleared, which is called the auto clear feature of Password Gorilla. It also gives you features to organize groups and subgroups that can be created to organize passwords for different combinations of websites. Suppose there is a group which is called social media. So all your passwords for a social media website can be stored in one group, and then that group can be used to access those passwords. The next password manager that I want to discuss with you is G Password Manager. It is very simple, it is very lightweight and cross-platform utility for managing and accessing passwords. It is published under the terms of the Apache license. It also allows users to securely store passwords, URLs in the database. Suppose there's a URL which you want to store securely in a database, you can do that with G Password Manager. The added entries can be marked as favorites. So few websites that you frequently visit, those entries can be marked as favorites, which then can be accessed by right clicking the system tray icon. The passwords and other login information shown in the screen can be kept hidden based on user preferences. You don't want people to see it, you can keep it hidden as per your preferences. This is the GUI of the G Password Manager. Pretty plain, pretty simple and easy to use. In this, you can also create access to your favorite website. You can keep favorite web pages and then you can access those favorite web pages with password and username combination from the tray icon. There is a feature which can quickly fill passwords. You can drag those onto the forms for quickly filling out and avoiding key press. This software also allows you a search bar to search passwords that are needed. Sometimes the entries can become too large, so you can easily search passwords for websites through this software. It also has a password generator which the user can define options and generate the password for his own use with a single click. It also gives you a tray icon wherein you can quickly launch favorite websites. With this, we finish the features of G Password Manager. The next password manager that we want to discuss is Password Safe. Password Safe is a simple and free open source application initiated by Bruce Schneier and released in 2002. Now, Password Safe is hosted on SourceForge and developed by a group of volunteers. It is well known for its ease of use. In this software, it is possible to organize passwords based on user preference, which makes it easy for the user to remember. The whole database backup and a recovery option are available for ease of use. Passwords are kept hidden, making it difficult for shoulder surfing. Password Safe is licensed under the artistic license. Password Safe is licensed under the artistic license. The GUI is very simple, enabling even a beginner to use it. You don't need much technical knowledge to understand the GUI, and these are made for everyone to use it with ease. This software supports multiple databases, and different databases can be created for each category. Suppose you have a category of email providers. So you can create a different database which can store passwords for all email passwords together at one place. The decryption of the password database is done in the RAM, which leaves no trace of the login details in the hard drive. That means the decryption in this software is safe from leaving any traces. Again, the software also has a password generator, which generates strong and lengthy passwords. It also supports advanced search function, which allows users to search within the different fields. Since it is built by Bruce, it uses two-fish algorithm to encrypt the database. With this, we come to the end of this module. In this module, we had seen different password managers and how one can use each one of them. Thank you, and have a happy and safe browsing.